Hello everyone. So today we are going to start with our next topic, that is the LZW encoding, which is dictionary based technique. In the earlier video lectures, I've already described and told you how to work on with LZ77 and LZ78 dictionary based technique. So this particular encoding technique is also from the same family, and this particular is going to define how we are going to work on with the encoding or the compression technique of LZW. So first of all, let's see how the name of this particular compression technique came up. It was named after the scientist's name. The three scientists, those who developed this particular algorithm, were Abraham Lempel, Jacob Zev and Terry Welch. So all these surnames, Lempel, Zev and Welch, abbreviations are taken and named as this particular compression technique. This is a lossless compression algorithm, which is very simple and is dictionary based. Now this particular was developed after the LZ77 and LZ78 compression techniques. Why there was a need of this particular algorithm to be defined? It was for the reason that it was more compact. If you all remember, or if you have seen my videos, earlier videos of LZ77 and 78, then we have seen in LZ77, the output is triplet. That is, we take the offset, the length of match and the next symbol. So this was the triplet that goes as the output, while in LZ78 it was doublet, that was the index and the symbol, right? Now here in LZW we only have a single parameter in the output, right? That is defined as I. So you can see this particular output has been reduced as compared to LZ77 and 78. Now let's see how we work on with this particular technique. To make it more clear, what we can do is we can take on with an example through which we can describe how we can encode a given string or a sequence of symbols. Let me tell you certain things in the encoding of LZW. That is, first of all, in the question, you will always be given as the sequence which you have to encode, and you will be given an initial dictionary in which index and entry will be given. Here you can see in the question, this is the sequence which you have to encode, and the initial dictionary which is defined is this particular. 1, B bar, 2, A symbol, 3, B symbol is placed, at 4th position, O is there, and at 5th position, W is there. And we have to find out the output. So this is the final output, the solution. Let's see how we have attained this particular output. Now in this LZW, we have to maintain the dictionary. This particular is called as the dictionary in which we have the index and the entry. The initial index and entry is given, which we are going to set here till 5, which is already given in the question. Now let's start up with this. Now you have to remember certain things in this procedure, how we are going to encode it. We are going to start up with the first symbol to be encountered, that is W. Now you see W is already there in the initial dictionary at the 5th position. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to take one more alphabet. That will be WA. Now you can see, is WA defined in the dictionary? This is the initial dictionary. No, WA is not defined. I'm going to enter these particular in the dictionary in one after the other steps. So W is A is not there, not present in the above dictionary. So I'm going to make a new entry for WA at the sixth position. So at the sixth position, I'll write WA. Okay. Now, one more thing we have to remember is when we encode it, let's write here how we are going to encode. The index of the first alphabet is taken on, right? We have entered WA in the sixth position, but I am going to take the index of only W in the output. So what is the index for W? Index for W is 5. So I'm going to write 5 here. Okay. Now, one more thing we have to remember. When we have started up with this, we have to take one alphabet which is already taken earlier. That means earlier we have entered WA. Now I'm going to take A again. A, B. Now see, A is already there. I'm going to see AB is there in my dictionary till sixth. No, AB is not there. So I'm going to make a new entry for seventh at the seventh of AB, right? So AB I have entered. Now how I'm going to encode? I'm going to encode for the symbol A only, right? For the symbol A, what is the index for A? It is 2. So I'm going to write 2 here. Now further, I'm going to take again the earlier symbol. We have to overlap. Now see here, we have to overlap. So I'll take it from B. B, B. B, B is there? No, B, B is not there. So at the 8th index, I'm going to enter B, B. How I'm going to give the encoding for this? I'm going to encode only for the symbol B index. So B is at which position? It is at the 3rd position. So I'm going to write 3. Okay. Now again, I'm going to overlap it. I'm going to start up with from BA. Now you see BA. BA is present in the dictionary till 8. No, it is not present. So I'm going to make a new entry at 9th position and enter BA. Now, what will be the code for BA? B index will be taken. So what is the index for B? Index for B is again 3. So I'm going to again write 3 for this. Now, moving further, we have done till here. I'm going to take again A and B bar. Now see, A, B bar is present here till 9th. No. So I'm going to make a new entry at 10th position, that is A, B bar. Now what will be the encoding for this particular A, B bar? Only the code index for A is taken, and what is the index for A? It is 2. So I'm going to write 2. Now again, taking it from B bar. So B bar W, because only B bar is already there. B bar W, I'm going to check. B bar W is there? No, B bar W is not there. So I'm going to make a new entry at 11th position for B bar W. And what will be the code for this B bar W? I'm going to check B bar is at which index. So B bar is at first index. So I'm going to write 1 as the code for this. Now starting up with another factor, that is, now again I'm going to check for W because I have to overlap this. So W already there in the index at 5th position. WA, yes, it is already there at the 6th position, right? So I am going to take one more alphabet, WAB. Now WAB is not present till 11th. So I'm going to make a new entry at 12th position for WAB. Now just make sure here that I am going to encode it for the symbol WAB. I have taken WAB and I'm going to encode for the index WA. I'm going to encoded for WA, not only for W, but for WA, right? So what is the index for WA? It is 6. So I'm going to write here code as 6. This is for WA, right? WAB, I'm going to code for WA. Okay. Now taking on from here again, B. BB, yes, BB is already present at 8th position. So I'm going to take one more alphabet, BBA. BBA is not present till 12th. So I'm going to make a new entry at 13th position for BBA. Okay, now what will be the code for this BBA? I'll take only BB, and BB is at which index? BB is at 8th index. So it will be 8. Okay, so where were we? We have done till BBA. Now I'm going to take AB bar. AB bar is already present. Yes, AB bar is already present at 10th position. So I'm going to take one more alphabet, AB bar W. AB bar W is present? No, till 13th, AB bar is not present. So AB bar W, new entry at 14th position is done. Now how I am going to encode it? I'm going to encode for AB bar only. Now where is AB bar? AB bar is at 10th position. So I'm going to write the code for this is 10th. We can separate it with the help of commas. Right? So now moving further, in the same way, what we are going to do, we were where were we? We are here. From W, we have to start. WA, it's already there at 6th position. So one more alphabet, WAB. WAB, you can also find it at 12th position, already entered. So I'm going to encounter one more alphabet, WAB. So I'm going to take 4 characters now, right? WABB, it's not present anywhere. So at 15th position, new entry is done for WABB. Now, how I am going to encode it? I'm going to take these 3 alphabets together and going to find the index for this. So this is WAB. WAB is at which position? 12th position. So the code for this will be 12. Moving further. Now we have BA. BA is already there at 9th position. So one more alphabet, let's encounter BAB bar. BAB bar is not present anywhere. So new entry is done at 16th index, that is BAB bar. How to encode it? I will encode it for BA. Where is the index for BA? BA is at 9th index. So I'm going to write 9 as the code for this one. Now B bar W. B bar W is already there at 11th position, right? So I'm going to encounter one more, B bar WA. So B bar WA is not present anywhere. So new entry is made at 17th position, that is B bar WA. How to encode it? We have to encode it with the help of these two, that is B bar W. So B bar W is at which position? It is at 11th index. So the output code will be, it will be 11. Now moving further, where were we? We were at this position, B bar W A B, right? We have done the entry at 17th, B bar W A. Now again, I'm going to take A, I'm going to overlap AB. AB is already there at which position? AB is already there at 7th position. So I'm going to take one more alphabet, ABB. So ABB is not present. New entry is made at 18th index, that is ABB. Now how I'm going to encode it? Again, I'm going to take only AB. Where is AB in the dictionary? AB is at the 7th position. So 7 index is taken. It will be encoded as 7. Now we have, next is B. B, A. So BA is already present at 9th position. You can see 9th position BA is there. So I'm going to take one more alphabet or character, BA B bar. We can see BA B bar is already present at 16th position. So one more alphabet will be encountered, BA B bar W. This is W, right? So BA B bar W is taken as a whole, and I cannot find BA B bar W in the complete dictionary. So new entry is made at 19th position, that is BA B bar W. How to encode it? I'll encode it with the help of these three alphabets, that is BA B bar. So BA B bar is at which position? 16th position, you can see. That is 16th index. So the code for this will be 16. Now you can just see here and tally the output. That is, we have got this particular output as I. That is only one parameter for LZW, that is the output. It will be 52331689101117. So this is how we are going to encode, and this will be the final answer for this encoding of LZW. So I hope you have understood this particular technique. Thank you very much.